I am thrilled, delighted to be here, and very honored, in fact, to sit on this panel and to speak a little bit about our work at the University of Delaware in the education and training of conservation professionals, and about the field of conservation in general, nationally and internationally, and the work that we do in partnership to build an awareness of society and cultures and to preserve our global cultural heritage. At the University of Delaware, we're involved in a myriad of projects. I'll speak about some of them, but I can't go into a lot of detail, obviously. But I do want to say at the onset how instrumental NEH has been in all of our work. We have received decades, over 20 years of support from the NEH in preservation and access from both the Challenge Grant Office and direct funding. And this has really enabled us to strengthen our graduate program, to broaden our curriculum, and to really move forward in working very globally. And so we are incredibly grateful. Also, NEH funding has supported a project that we're engaged in building public scholars among graduate students in material culture studies so that they can share their research appropriately with the public and get them excited about what they do. In our graduate program, we're working with historically black colleges and universities in the preservation of their photographic heritage. Our undergraduates were recently working in Peru, as you see here, on the preservation of a tempera mural in a 17th century church that was damaged by the earthquake. We're working in St. Petersburg, Russia, at the State Hermitage Museum, working with the conservators there to develop photograph conservation. That's actually my field. And it's interesting to note that in the entire country of Russia, this is a very new field. At the State Hermitage Museum, which has 400,000 photographs, there are no photograph conservators. So we've been involved in a major project to educate and train and to work in collaboration with them both in Russia and in the United States. And of course, we benefited greatly. The Art Conservation Department at the university includes a PhD program, an undergraduate program, and a master's level program jointly sponsored with a Winitar Museum. And our students, and I'm going to focus primarily in the master's level program, the work that we do in our partnerships, but this just gives you an idea of the variety of different disciplines that students can major in. It's a 3-year master's program. For those of you who aren't familiar with the field of art conservation, well, it's a fabulous field, and it's a real combination of art and science. To get into this field, you have to have coursework in chemistry, art history, anthropology, museum studies, studio art, and conservation experience. We just admitted our current 10 students. They have an average of 3,500 hours of conservation experience before they were admitted into the program. And you specialize in all these different areas. The point is that the issues that you study in terms of the preservation of cultural heritage is true around the world. So my field in photograph conservation, this is acetate negatives that deteriorate. They deteriorate in the United States, and they deteriorate in Africa, and they deteriorate in Japan. And we need to ensure that our students are well prepared to deal with these problems around the world and to understand the challenges that exist in these different countries and their different institutions, but understanding the mechanism of deterioration as well. Studying about objects conservation, decorative and painted surfaces. This is the interior of Shangri-La in Hawaii. Students who've worked here in these Islamic interiors have gone on to work in other Islamic interiors around the world. Our program is a 3-year program, as I mentioned, and not to get into a whole lot of detail about the program, but to understand it, I think you understand conservation and cultural heritage preservation and how that does help to build connections. So this is one of our students who's working on a sword from Sudan. I don't want to show you a lot of before and afters, but I just had to show you this detail of the damage here, and here it is after conservation. But it's not just a matter of treating the sword, it's a matter of understanding why it's important, why it's relevant, what cultures used it, and beginning to relate to what's going on around the world so that they can be better prepared to preserve not just this artifact, but all kinds of artifacts. Working in Liverpool on using lasers to clean sculpture and outdoor monuments, a new technique in the preservation of cultural heritage that is really used internationally. We're focused on introducing a broad spectrum of techniques from assessment to conservation treatment. Here again is an image of someone working on photographs from historically black colleges and preventive conservation. And we have spent considerable time over the years working on the Mississippi Gulf Coast following Hurricane Katrina. This is the Jefferson Davis home before Katrina. You probably have seen this all in the news. This is what it looked like after Katrina. And our students and faculty, and we collaborated through a series of grants with graduate students across the nation and experts in Europe to help to preserve not just the artifacts and the materials here, but across the Mississippi Gulf Coast. This has allowed us then to be more involved internationally in all kinds of global catastrophes. Most recently, thanks to technology, I've been able to spend quite a bit of time on email advising colleagues in Japan about the preservation of photographs following the tsunami. They have found hundreds and thousands of photographs, and they've obviously been terribly damaged, but they've been able to recover these through washing techniques and to make them available to the Japanese people. And they, of course, have relocated hundreds of miles from where they were lost. But it's really a wonderful project, and one that we've been able to be engaged in, not on site, I want to be sure that's clear, but at least in helping in some small way. A lot of work is being done in the United States, again, thanks to NEH funding, not just through graduate programs, but also through organizations such as Heritage Preservation. And Larry Rieger is here. He's the president of Heritage Preservation. They've been a real leader in strengthening our understanding of what to do in the response to disasters of all kinds, and developing this salvage wheel, which you see here in Arabic. It's been translated now into six different languages, how to respond to emergencies in the first 24 or 48 hours. Again, much of this made possible through the NEH. Advancing awareness about materials and techniques. One of our students working most recently on a Mesopotamian bull, 3000 BC, from what's now southern Iraq. This is a copper alloy. You can see it in radiograph. It was embedded in concrete and wrapped in bandages, and now they had to sort of develop how do you stabilize this very fragile surface and removing the concrete as well, and developed innovative techniques to do so. We work around the world, most recently in China, in a temple in northeastern China, preserving 12th century murals. And this has been a fabulous project in collaboration with Shenghua University in Beijing, where students, undergraduate and graduate students from both universities, are working together in the preservation of these fabulous murals, documenting their condition, understanding what the pigments are, the binders, and how to preserve them. It is essential that we build international connections and that we interact effectively with public and private sectors of all kinds, and that, of course, as we've all been saying, that we work collaboratively beyond our disciplines. And this is certainly true. By the way, I see people smiling. I'm going so quickly, you don't have a chance to appreciate some of these photographs, but this is a great and very unusual albumin print on the right. And actually wonderful daguerreotype on the left as well, in terms of collaboration. You can see that hand coming out. But the need to do this, to work collaboratively, and to begin to broaden our scope in terms of education and training. There are so many needs and so many ways, of course, that we benefit through doing so. I've had the great privilege to most recently teach in Bogota, and in India, and really around the world. And it's interesting in terms of photograph conservation, both in Bogota and in India, in fact, there is one trained photograph conservator in both of those countries. And so the opportunity to collaborate, to work with them, to learn from them, to benefit from their photographic heritage, and to help to preserve it is really quite remarkable. And our students are doing the same. Finally, to focus on two very particular projects, both in the Middle East, and funded from a variety of different sources. One is an ongoing project that we're involved in preserving the rich photographic heritage of the Middle East. And this is in collaboration with the Arab Image Foundation in Beirut, Lebanon, also the Metropolitan Museum of Art, the Getty Conservation Institute. And this has been funded by primarily funded by the Andrew W. Mellon Foundation. Of course, in the Middle East, the focus in terms of cultural heritage has been more on archaeological materials and historic sites and landscapes than necessarily on photographic materials. But the photographic materials are rich. And so the first part of this project, it's a three-year initiative, is to build awareness, to begin to survey collections in Northern Africa, the Levant, the Gulf states, to identify where are these photographs, in many cases held privately as opposed to in public institutions, and to begin to build awareness about their value and importance for understanding cultural heritage, not only in the cultures, not only in the Middle East, but around the world. And so we are, over 3 years, working to develop workshops in Cairo, Doha, and Beirut that will bring together custodians of collections throughout the Middle East to talk about the preservation of these magnificent works and to build collaborations around the world. It's been really an honor and a privilege to be involved in this project, which has really taken on. And in fact, it's really fabulous for the Arab Image Foundation, but because of this, they then have secured an enormous amount of funding from other sources to strengthen their work in the Middle East. And then finally, another project that we're very proud of is in Erbil, Iraq. And this is focused in the education and training of Iraqis in the preservation of their cultural heritage. And what you're seeing here is the Institute for Conservation in Erbil. This was a library that was in very bad condition, actually. And we drew up plans. The University of Delaware has been working on this project with many partners, the Kurdish Regional Government, the U.S. Embassy in Baghdad, the State Department, Winterthur Museum, and the Walters Art Museum to begin with. It's now broadened. But we drew up plans to renovate this library, and I have to say, even I, when I went there, I mean, you just have tears in your eyes when you see this place. It is just so phenomenal. And it has classrooms for education and training, conservation laboratories to die for. I really believe that this center will be a center not just for Iraq, but for the entire Middle East. There's just nothing like it. Beautiful labs, beautifully equipped, and then on the other side of the library building are dormitory spaces so that the Iraqis can stay there for these courses, and they can come up from Baghdad and don't have to worry about where they're staying. And this is, again, for the entire country. As I mentioned, it's a partnership. It's been going on now for a couple of years and has just been recently refunded for this year under the leadership of the University of Delaware. And we're working to expand it. So right now the courses focus on the conservation of cultural heritage. We want to expand into historic preservation, archaeology, and museum studies. We offer 6 months of training, a certificate in conservation. The students are individuals who work in Iraq in all the museums, libraries, and archives. So they come for training, and then, of course, they take that knowledge back and apply it to the preservation of their heritage. Our goal, of course, is to build preservation capacity, sustainability, and global partnerships. And so we're bringing in not just the Americans, but we're bringing in the Italians, the British, the Japanese, all to sort of work in this collective environment. We've established an American-Iraqi advisory council that is responsible for fundraising and advocacy and strengthening this curriculum so we ensure that it can be sustained in the years ahead. So far, 34 Iraqi heritage professionals have been trained, and we also offer these short courses, for example, in emergency response, disaster preparedness, integrated pest management, environmental control, archaeological site management, etc. And most importantly, of course, is the spirit of reconciliation and passion that's shared by these students. We have regular conference calls. I had one yesterday to talk about funding. And I was talking to our academic director. The faculty are leading experts in conservation and preservation, primarily in the United States, but also now around the world, who go in and teach for two-week segments in their area of expertise. But we have an academic director who's there. And I was talking to Jessie yesterday, mentioned that I would be speaking today on the Hill. And I asked her, you know, what should I say? And she said, you know, there was a great moment actually yesterday morning with all the students. These are students from all over Iraq, the Arabs, the Kurds, the Christians, the Muslims, all working together. And she said they were all talking about how they now have a shared common language, that they are focused on the preservation of this rich global cultural heritage. So I end actually with this quote. I have also taught in Beirut with the Arab Image Foundation. It was sort of the precursor to this other project. And at one point, I was talking to one of the students saying, you know, we're investing this time. We believe it's really important. Hey, how do you feel about the preservation of cultural heritage? And he said the continuation of cultural events is a form of resistance to war. And certainly we have seen in our education and training around the world how this really brings the world together. I believe through the preservation of cultural heritage, it's very possible. I've seen it time and time again. And again, so much of this, so much of the work that we've done at the graduate level, at the undergraduate level,